right, guys, we are here with Greg. He is the technician specialist over at Polaris. He's our go-to guy when we've got any questions about any of the Polaris gear. We're here with the Pro R. Talk us through everything. We're going to start up the front here. Massive A-arms. These are bigger than anything I've seen before, surely.
Yeah, so they've got the new box steel A-arms. They're far stronger than the old ones. If you check out underneath there too, you've got these new hubs that are much stronger, stronger ball joints, stronger tie rods, you name it. If there's something we could improve, we've improved it. Brakes are bigger, three piston calipers, stopping power is unbelievable. And just while we're at the front, the lights, front, the style, it's definitely different to our previous models.
I like that.
It stands out, especially when you turn the key on and you get those marker lights light up.
Yeah, that is cool. And now, I like the orange kind of on the A-arms. It looks kind of cool. It pops, it stands out. Wheel track's bigger. These guards are aftermarket. They're obviously not standard, but they just stop a little bit of the mud flying up into the cab, yeah?
Yeah, that's right, that's right. But one of the biggest things you'll see here too is our dual valve shockers. So we've gone with the Fox dual valve dynamic suspension, which is a big improvement on our previous shockers. So not only does it do compression adjustment, it does rebound adjustment as well on the fly. There's an ECU in there that's controlling that 200 times a second.
Wow.
It's monitoring everything you're doing with the vehicle and will adjust your compression and rebound to suit the driving behavior you've got.
Cool.
You've also got drive modes. So you can change your suspension modes depending on what kind of riding you want. So you can have it nice and plush for a comfort ride, or you can go into full sport mode for if you're going to be doing some competition work or anything like that.
Cool.
The good thing is it also integrates the power steering adjustment as well. So by changing your drive modes, you'll change your steering behavior as well.
Cool. We're going to come further around. These aren't the stock tyres either. I think we've gone up an inch on the tyres.
We have, yep. So these came with the accessory kit that we've got with the vehicle. But they do look impressive and they do go well. The standard tyres, though, you'll be impressed with those. They still look huge.
Cool. Can I keep going around?
Yep.
Same door we've always seen, opens from the front.
Yep.
Bucket seats all around with the full harness seat belt.
Full harness seat belts, nice and secure. There is more leg room in this model as well.
Okay.
So they did improve the leg room in the vehicle. So for the front and back passengers, so it's more roomy.
Cool. And obviously the Perspex windscreen, not standard. We have put it on there for protection.
Yep. We added a few accessories to this. It's the first one in Australia. So
yes.
Comes in, let's put some accessories on it, make it good.
Cool. We'll keep going further back. Obviously, you've got the seats at the back. You've got the speaker behind the head so you can blast
100%.
The tunes.
We've got awesome sound system in this thing. Really good sound. You can hear it over the engine without a problem at all.
Cool. Cool.
She's a great vehicle.
We're going to move to the back here. Explain this trailing arm system to us. This obviously grey pole that sits through the middle of it. That affects the toe of the vehicle.
That's right. We've got an adjustable toe on the rear wheels, so we can actually change the angle of the rear wheels, and that can affect the handling. So you can set this vehicle up for your riding style and for the way you want to use it. And it's an adjustable setup. The previous one was fixed.
Okay, so. Cool. Now have a look at this suspension travel. I'm about 6'2". And it's coming up halfway up my arm. It's nearly at my shoulder before I get to the mudguard. That's got to be the longest we've seen in a RZR.
Yeah, definitely. She's got the longest travel suspension.
Yep.
But as you noticed before when you were driving it and you did that huge tabletop, you overshot it.
Yep.
And still landed without moving.
It was like carpet.
Right.
All right, cool. We'll keep moving our way around. We're going to get back to the back A-arms and hubs and bits and pieces.
Yep.
These are bolstered bigger in the Pro R.
100%. So bigger A-arms, bigger control arms, everything. Everything about this vehicle is bigger and better. That was the whole purpose of the vehicle. If we're going to put a 2-litre engine in a side-by-side, we want to make sure it's going to withstand it.
Yep.
So we've got stronger axles, bigger suspension, same thing, unitised hub bearings out at the wheels.
Yep.
The design of this is just radically improved.
Cool. Little tray compartment to carry whatever you need to do. If you go trail running for the day, that's pretty cool. The rear bar for a bit of extra protection. That's all standard.
We've got an accessory box in the back here too, so you've got some storage back there as well.
Cool.
So
I like the look of the single pipe hanging out the back.
Yeah,
it
that's
looks
right.
cool. I think it's a good look. It always looks good on a RZR. Yep. We'll keep coming around, same over here.
This
really
is
quickly.
This is it.
This is what it's all about.
This is where it is, the 2-litre engine. As you can see, north-south orientation. They've got it designed in a way so we can keep our engine compartment nice and narrow. It's a 2-litre engine. Not a new engine. It's been used in the Slingshot since 2020, been in development since 2018. It's a proven engine. It's been used for a while. So we haven't gone and developed a brand new thing, put it in it and hope for the best.
Yep.
This thing is tried and tested. So
cool.
We have made a few improvements today. Being a RZR, we wanted more performance. So we've gone with a little bit higher compression pistons and a few other little tweaks.
Cool.
So she is a performance powerhouse.
Cool. All right, well, coming down the side, one of the other things that kind of stood out to me straight away was kind of ground clearance.
Yes.
When you're getting down here, it's more ground clearance than previous RZRs as well?
It is, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So the vehicle's got a higher stance, but it's got a wider footprint as well. So being higher doesn't cause us to have any stability issues because we're wider also.
Yeah, 74 inches now as opposed to 72 was the biggest beforehand. So you've got an extra 2 inches of width.
That's right. So and it is a stable vehicle. The good thing too with the Dynamics dual valve suspension is if you're cornering, it's adjusting the shockers. So it'll stiffen up the outer shockers so you won't get the body lean anyway.
Yep.
So it does all of these type of things. It also, it takes into account braking. You put your foot on the brake, it detects that you're braking, and it'll feel the G-sensor will actually detect that you're decelerating. It'll stiffen up the front. So you don't get a nosedive when you're doing braking.
Cool.
It's got so many independent adjustments it'll make to the suspension to make sure you get the best ride.
And last but not least, we'll have a look inside the driver's seat here. Telescopic steering wheel, which is cool, so front and back, up and down.
That's right, yeah, so it's steering wheel adjustment. We've got our usual up and down tilt like all of our others, but we can also telescope it in and out.
Yep.
So you can adjust that to suit your specific seating position.
Cool. Flick that ignition on for us.
Yep.
GPS.
Yeah, GPS, it comes with a ride command.
Yep.
So that's what Polaris use for all of our ride command displays. Its ride command software has GPS built in. It will display our change of suspension modes.
Yep.
Controls on the steering wheel. So we've got audio controls and we've got suspension controls on the steering wheel.
Yep.
Including the oh no button. So the X button on our steering wheel. If you get into trouble and you come across a large drop-off or something that you weren't prepared for, you can hit and hold that button, the suspension will go full firm. So it just helps you get out of trouble.
And driver modes on the dash to flick between your race, your rock, your comfort.
100%.
Cool, and suspension on the steering wheel.
Yep, definitely.
She's, cool.
She's the full package, really.
Yeah. But as you can see, it's a pretty impressive package. You can see how tall it is. You can see how solid the new cage is. The frame's all new for this model. So, you know, we're looking forward to jumping in back in it. We've done a bit of testing today. We're going to do a little bit more. But it is a very impressive machine to just to stand back and look at compared to anything else that we've ever tested.
Yeah, that's right. She's a full one-piece welded roll frame, which is far stronger and far more rigid.
Yeah.
It helps the overall dynamics of the vehicle.
Yeah. There you go. It's an absolute beast, and we can't wait to do more testing.